Welcome to the new features of CoPrA 10. With CoPrA 10, the flexibility in handling color channels has been greatly improved. All settings that affect channels, such as channel definition, channel combination, or to enable / disable channels, can be configured in the channel settings. The channel definition determines the assignment of the channels whether it is a primary color, black, or another gamma extending spot color. The channel combination is set to auto by default for all multicolor channels. The channel combination specifies which multicolor channels to combine to expand the color gamut. This assignment can be done manually or automatically. The default channel order is defined in the measurement data. In this case, it is CMO VY KG. In ink definition, when you enable the auto feature and click on the apply button, CoPrA automatically calculates and selects the ink definitions that results in the largest gamut. Here is another example with different measurement data. As you can see, auto is enabled by default for the channel combination. When you enable auto for the channel definition and click apply, CoPrA changes both the channel combination and channel definition that results in largest color gamut. You can see the changes in both the channel settings dialog and in the 3D gamut view. In the printer profiling module, there is an option to select a G7 correction. This new feature corrects the tonal value curves of the measurement data to correspond to the gray balance conditions of the G7 method, and includes these adjustments in the resulting ICC profile. The new G7 correction in the printer profiling tool corrects the tonal value curves of the measurement data to correspond to the gray balance conditions of the G7 method, and includes these adjustments in the resulting ICC profile. The G7 correction also applies to the CMYK parts of a multicolor measurement file, and the additional channels will be corrected according to ISO 20654, also known as SCTV, spot color tone value. Here in our example, you can see the comparison of the ECG profile data in Colorant without G7 correction and with G7 correction. In the DeviceLink Profiling module, there is also an option to apply G7 correction called Apply G7 Properties. The Apply G7 Properties adds a correction so that the device link conversion complies to the G7 method. This option is not limited to G7-based source profiles. The G7 correction can be applied to any device link conversion when it is enabled. The device link editing workflows have been improved in the settings window by simplifying the profile selection and adding useful information to the patch information section. The source profile and the target profile are selected automatically if it is found in the computer system or if the profiles were embedded in the device link profile. For the created device link profile, the source and target profiles are of no importance, but it is useful as color patches will then be displayed with true colors in CoPrA as well. The patch information section has been improved by showing more relevant and informative values. In the source color space section, the original unedited edit target value is used as a reference. In the target color space section, there are two areas that are displayed. One is the before editing section, which shows the pure conversion to the largest profile. Two is the after editing section, which additionally shows the impact of the edits. The difference between the two can be seen in the TAC, the DCS values, and as well as a Delta E2000 value. The edits to the sample image have an effect on yellow. It was reduced from 6.4 to 3.5%. The difference after conversion and editing has a Delta E2000 of 1.1. Enabling the secondaries option in the expert options section affects again the yellow channel. The exception increases the value for yellow from 3.5 to 5%, and the Delta E2000 distance to before editing, which is now 0.5. The calculated Delta E2000 distance between these two values, 3.5% after editing and 5% after editing plus the expert options, is a value in the brackets, 0.6. In the Image Conversion module, there is now a zoom function for the image preview. This allows a user to zoom in on image details. This gives a better comparison of the complete user-defined color management workflow on the selected image. There are three ways to adjust the zoom. One is to use the mouse wheel, in which you move the mouse wheel up to zoom in, or you can move it down to zoom out. Two, you can use the zoom input field, in which you change the zoom percentage. And three, use the arrow keys next to the zoom input field. In the linearization module, when you use either of these calculation modes, linearization according to G7, or the other option, which is linearization according to G7 and ISO 20654, the profile report will now contain information for a G7 evaluation based on the measurement and calculation data. For more information on CoPrA, please visit our website